Hey guys, Black Cherry here. So I just got back from the doctor's, and my doctor said that she liked my new style because I have my natural hair out. The last video I made, I had my hair in bantu knots, but it was covered in a scarf, so you guys couldn't see it. But my mom said my hair grew more, and it's way healthier looking or whatever, because I've been taking care of it and twisting it every night and moisturizing it like crazy, and I love to wash my hair, like, I love it. So today's video is going to be, I guess I could just say 10 things that I do not like when guys do, or whatever. Things that I find unattractive that guys do. There you go. 10 things. So let me start with number one. I do not like when a guy talks like, oh, I'm gonna do this and I'm gonna do that, and then when we link up, it's a totally different thing, and I'm just like, okay, what happened to Mr. I'm gonna do this, do that? And I'm not saying because I expect you to do this, but if you are constantly telling me you're gonna do something, then I kind of start believing, like, okay, he's gonna do this, he's gonna do that, and then when you don't, I'm like, I'm wasting my time. Number two, I cannot stand when a guy actually says, okay, when I'm basically angry and I write a whole paragraph and I'm like, I'm so mad, da 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 da, and then they're just like, okay. I'm like, what? Like, okay. I can't stand that. If I am writing a paragraph to you, even if I'm not mad, if I'm telling you, hey, I like you, I have feelings for you, or whatever, just say something other than okay. Okay, I hate when people do that. I also, number three. I cannot stand, and this is mostly for a black guy, when a black man is not woke. I hate that. That pisses me off, because I'm like, if I'm speaking how I feel about how what's going on in the black community and just black people in general and everything, and you're kind of just like, well, all lives matter or whatever, I'm kind of like, okay, sure, I guess you could say that. And if they're just very unaware with what's really going on in the world, I cannot deal with that. That just, don't be unwoke with me. Just don't, because I'm not gonna find it attractive. Number four, I cannot stand, most girls are like this, I cannot stand when a guy lies, and everybody lies, but I cannot stand when they lie about the simplest thing, and when they play with your emotions, like when they're like, I really like you, I really want to be with you, you know, I love you, I adore you, and then it's like, they don't show that at all, like they start treating you like shit, basically, and you're just like, I thought you liked me. And I just can't feel that. That goes into number five, what I do not like, is when you move on from that guy that treated you like shit, and then they get mad at you because you moved on. I do not like when the guy does that, when they're like, what about me? And it's like, I spent like almost 2 years with you and you didn't even do anything. You didn't want to do anything for me. You didn't want to cater to me. I was catering to you all the time and you didn't do anything for me. So I'm supposed to just sit here and be like, okay, here's everything I have, you know, and be stressed out over you? I think not, sir, okay? Number six. I cannot stand laying in the bed and you act like I can't even touch you. I don't know why you do that. I do not like that. I can't. I was talking to this one guy, and it was like, I was a young kid, okay? I was little. And even then, I was like, ugh, because he had bad breath. And I was just like, ugh. And I'm not trying to be bougie or whatever. I'm not trying to be like, you know, everybody with bad breath is just, it's their fault. Some people have like an actual problem. But he was just dirty all around. Like, he didn't, he just smelled weird. Everything was just weird about him. I cannot deal. If you're gonna be dirty, just don't. I don't understand. Just be clean. Okay, I know most guys are kind of like, you know, they're just kind of boyish or whatever. They have that kind of dirty edge look or whatever. But don't do that with me, please. Like, I can't deal with that. Number 7. When they're not loyal, I guess. Because I don't like when they're not loyal and when they basically just see other people while they're supposedly supposed to be with you, and they're talking to other girls, and I don't, like, for some reason, when I see a guy like another girl's picture, I don't really care as much for some reason. I know a lot of girls are like, why'd you like this bitch's picture? Who's this bitch? And I'm kind of just like, I guess, but maybe it's because I haven't found the right one, so maybe if I did have, like, a guy that I legitimately really liked and he did that, maybe I would get mad. But just talking to another girl, being flirty with another girl, just any of that, I don't like that at all. Most girls don't, unless they really just don't care. Number 8. I don't like when a guy clearly does not care about you and he's just wanting you to have sex, or he wants pictures of you and stuff like that. I cannot deal with that. The thing is with me, if you're one of those guys, if you're a fuckboy, just say you're a fuckboy. I cannot stand when a guy is a fuckboy. Actually, that's gonna be number 9. Okay, so let me just finish number 8 real quick. I do not like when you just want me for my body or my nudes or whatever you want me for. If you really do not like me because whatever, you just want me just because of my body or whatever, then just say that. Just tell me. Just say, hey, I just want you to do this so I can be like, okay, thanks for telling me, peace. Because I don't want to waste my time and I don't want to waste my energy. Honestly, I don't. Number 9. Fuckboys. I can't deal with fuckboys. I don't know how many times I have to stress that in any of my vlogs, that I cannot deal with them. They are annoying. And the most annoying thing about them is when you tell them they're a fuckboy and they're like, did you just call me a fuckboy? It's like, yes, I did call you a fuckboy. You are a fuckboy. Be a fuckboy. Okay? I do not like when they try to act like they're not, when they clearly are a fuckboy, okay? If you're asking me for nudes anytime, you're asking me for nudes and we just start talking and you're like, okay, do you know how to twerk or do you know how to do, I don't like that. That pisses me off. And then when I say, you're a fuckboy, I won't talk to you, and then you get all offended, like, you made that bed, now you lay in it. Like, you clearly are a fuckboy. Go be a fuckboy with somebody else. I do not have the time, I don't have the patience. I'm an Aries, we do not have patience for that kind of bullshit. So do not talk to me if you're a fuckboy, and do not get mad and try to get and have like a little debate with me because I said you're a fuckboy, because you are. Just go do that. You want to do that? Just like some girls want to be a hoe? Hey, go hoe. But just don't do it with me. Don't do that with me. And last but not least, number 10. I cannot stand when a guy is not a okay? Now let me just break down gentlemen right now, real quick. I'm not saying he spends all his money on you. I'm not saying he is just the perfect guy in the whole world, but I cannot stand when a guy, he doesn't open the door for you. Like, I don't like, basically, the generation of men today. Because most of them, unless they were really raised properly and they already had that installed in them when they were younger, so they already know, most of the guys today are shit. And I am not a feminist, I am not about that life at all, but I'm just saying most of them are shit, okay? I do not like when a guy lets you pay all the time. Like, example, okay? And I'm saying this from my experience, okay? And I don't even want to call this a date. I feel like I haven't even gone on a real date. But anyways, basically, you're on this little date, okay? And you guys know, you guys talked about it before, and you said, hey, we're going to do this, we're going to do that. And the guy knows, like, okay, this is the plan. And you've repeated it multiple times, okay? And then when it gets to where you're going, the person doesn't have money after they said they would get money to do the stuff you wanted to do with them. Okay? And I'm not saying I wanted to buy a whole bunch of stuff or go shopping. I literally wanted to just window shop. We couldn't even really do that because, yeah. But basically, at the end of the day, I paid for the person and the person's relative and myself to eat, okay? I feel like that shouldn't be going on. If you are a real gentleman and a real man, and I understand, some men, they're struggling, they can't always afford everything, but the thing is, let me know in advance. Tell me in advance, say, hey, so then I can switch around what we're gonna do. Because I don't wanna hear, oh, we can do this because I have this, and then as soon as we get there, it's like, oh, I don't have money. And of course I was gonna pay because I didn't wanna be rude. But the thing is, I don't want to pay. That's the thing. I want to be taken care of. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to be sound like a gold digger, because that's not what I am. Trust me. Like, I am so independent and sick, and I wish I wasn't, because, yeah, I could get a lot of stuff. But I don't. But the thing is, I really wish that men... I don't like when men are not gentlemen. Like, I just don't. So... those are my 10 things I find unattractive when guys do it or whatever. This video is really long. I'm sorry about that. I just wanted to say my little bits and pieces or whatever. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the Thursday. Thank God tomorrow's Friday. I'm kind of tired. I woke up at like 7 and I'm really tired. So, more videos should be coming up. I always say that, and then it's like a month and I post a video. So thanks for watching, guys. Sorry this video so long. Love you guys. Right ideas, we got